Hi, welcome to EPG Pathshala panel. We are in the paper entitled Advanced Spanish Grammar. I am Gaurav Kumar and I teach Spanish in the Center of Spanish, Portuguese, Italian and Latin American Studies in Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi. The name of this module is the Present Perfect Subjunctive. In this module, we will learn the use of the subjunctive with certain expressions, aunque, ojalá, quizá, tal vez, etc. These need to be assimilated in continuation of the earlier uses of the subjunctive. El pretérito perfecto de subjuntivo or present perfect subjunctive will also be dealt with in this module. Let us start with the first case of the subjunctive after aunque and por que. The subjunctive is used after adjective and adverbial expressions introduced by aunque and por, as they may imply uncertainty. Often, with these expressions, the speaker himself determines whether to use the subjunctive or not, depending on the idea he or she wishes to convey. Let us see the cases where the indicative is used. The indicative is used with aunque in case it introduces a sentence or question that expresses a known fact, a repeated action, or a general statement in the present. Also, in sentences that convey certain difficulty or obstacle, the use of the indicative with aunque reflects that the speaker is determined to act. Let us see some sentences to understand the context. Ayer, aunque no tenía ganas, fui de compras con mi madre. I repeat, ayer, aunque no tenía ganas, fui de comprar con mi madre. In English, the translation is, yesterday, although I didn't feel like, I went shopping with my mother. Let us take another example. Aunque es verano, la mujer siempre lleva guantes. I repeat, aunque es verano, la mujer siempre lleva guantes. The English equivalent is, although it is summer, the woman always wears gloves. Next example is, aunque le duele la pierna, va a participar en la carrera. I repeat, aunque le duele la pierna, va a participar en la carrera. The English version is, although his leg is paining, he is going to participate in the race. With all these sentences with aunque, you must have noticed that the indicative has been used. Now let us see some more examples with por que. Por que can also take the indicative if the action is already completed. Let us take one example. Por más que le insistí, él no aceptó mi invitación. I repeat, por más que le insistí, Él no aceptó mi invitación. In English, however much I insisted, he did not accept my invitation. We have seen the indicative usages. Now, let us go on to the formations of the subjunctive. If the action is incomplete or there is uncertainty, then the subjunctive is used. Let us see some examples. Saldré aunque llueva. Saldré aunque llueva. In English, I will go out although it may rain. Next example is, aunque sea difícil, yo intentaré hacerlo. I repeat, aunque sea difícil, yo intentaré hacerlo. In English, this sentence is, although it may be difficult, I will try doing it. Let us take another example. Aunque no me guste ella, pero iré a la fiesta con ella. I repeat. Aunque no me guste ella, pero iré a la fiesta con ella. In English, the sentence is, although I may not like her, but I will go to the party with her. Next sentence is, por mucho que estudies, no aprobarás el examen. I repeat, por mucho que estudies, no aprobarás el examen. The English equivalent is, no matter how much you study, you will not pass the exam. Por rico que sea, no nos ayudará. I repeat, por rico que sea, no nos ayudará. In English, however rich he may be, but he will not help us. Next sentence is, por atrevidos que sean, no van a ganar la batalla. I repeat, por atrevidos que sean, no van a ganar la batalla. The English version is, no matter how daring they are not going to win the battle. Let us take another example. Por muy barato que sea, no lo compres. I repeat, por muy barato que sea, no lo compres. The English equivalent is, no matter how cheap it is, don't buy it. Coming to the next stage, using the subjunctive after acaso, tal vez, or quizás, and ojalá. To express a possibility or hypothesis, subjunctive is used with the expressions of acaso, tal vez, or quizás, seguramente, probablemente, posiblemente. These expressions can take up the indicative depending upon the conviction of the speaker. Let us see the cases of the indicative. Use acaso, quizá, quizás, tal vez with the indicative form to express certainty. Let us see some examples. Tal vez volverán mañana los alumnos a pedir donación. I repeat. Tal vez volverán mañana los alumnos a pedir donación. The English equivalent is, Perhaps the students will return tomorrow to ask for donation. In this sentence, you can see that there is more certainty of the students returning the next day, and hence indicative is used. Let us see another example. Me ha prestado su motocicleta. Tal vez no le hace falta. I repeat. Me ha prestado su motocicleta. Tal vez no le hace falta. In English, the translation is, he has lent me his motorcycle. Perhaps he doesn't need it. Let's take the next example. Probablemente habré terminado el trabajo hasta las 7 de la tarde. I repeat. Probablemente habré terminado el trabajo hasta las 7 de la tarde. The English version is, probably I will have finished the work by 7 p.m. Let us see the next example. Quizá en otra vida tú y yo fuimos amantes. I repeat. Quizá en otra vida tú y yo fuimos amantes. In English, perhaps in another life, you and I were lovers. Next example is, seguramente nos veremos el sábado. I repeat, seguramente nos veremos el sábado. The English version is, very likely we will meet on Saturday. Particularly with seguramente, one has to be alert because it doesn't mean surely. Rather, it refers to a high probability of something happening. Let us take now the next example. Posiblemente, ellos llegan mañana por la mañana. I repeat. Posiblemente, ellos llegan mañana por la mañana. The English equivalent is, perhaps they arrive tomorrow morning. Next example is, ¿acaso están en el club de deportes? I repeat, ¿acaso están en el club de deportes? Perhaps they are at the sports club. Seguramente nos veremos el sábado. I repeat. Seguramente nos veremos el sábado. In English, very likely we will meet on Saturday. Particularly with seguramente, one has to be alert because it doesn't mean surely, rather it refers to a high probability of something happening. Let us take now the next example. Posiblemente ellos llegan mañana por la mañana. I repeat. Posiblemente ellos llegan mañana por la mañana. The English version is, perhaps they arrive tomorrow morning. The next example is, ¿acaso están en el club de deportes? I repeat, ¿acaso están en el club de deportes? Perhaps they are at the sports club. Let us now see the subjunctive formations with the same conjunctions. ¿Acaso ella me visite esta noche? I repeat, ¿acaso ella me visite esta noche? In English, perhaps she will visit me tonight. Next example is, ha llamado a decir que está enfermo. ¿Acaso esté en casa y da esta excusa para no ir al trabajo? I repeat, ha llamado a decir que está enfermo. ¿Acaso esté en casa y da esta excusa para no ir al trabajo? The English version is, he has called to say that he is sick. Perhaps he is at home and gives an excuse for not coming to work. Next example is, ¿saben dónde están los niños? No. ¿Acaso lo sepa Marta? I repeat, ¿sabes dónde están los niños? No. ¿Acaso lo sepa Marta? In English, do you know where are the kids? No. Perhaps Marta knows. Next example is, hoy no ha venido el profesor. Quizás él esté enfermo. I repeat, hoy no ha venido el profesor. Quizás él esté enfermo. The English version is, the professor hasn't come today. Perhaps he is sick. Next example is, quizás te cases o quizás no. I repeat, quizás te cases o quizás no. Perhaps you will get married or perhaps not. Next example is, quizá no venga nadie a ver el teatro. I repeat, quizá no venga nadie a ver el teatro. The English version is, maybe nobody will come to see the theater. Next example is, tal vez me digan mentiras. I repeat, tal vez me digan mentiras. The English version is, perhaps they will tell lies to me. Let us see another example. ¿Sabes dónde están los niños? No. ¿Acaso lo sepa Marta? I repeat, ¿sabes dónde están los niños? No. ¿Acaso lo sepa Marta? In English, do you know where are the kids? No. Perhaps Marta knows. Another example is, hoy no ha venido el profesor. Quizás él esté enfermo. I repeat, hoy no ha venido el profesor. Quizás él esté enfermo. In English, the professor hasn't come today. Perhaps he is sick. Next example is, quizás te cases o quizás no. I repeat, quizás te cases o quizás no. The English version is, perhaps you will get married or perhaps not. Let us see another example. Quizá no venga nadie a ver el teatro. I repeat, quizá no venga nadie a ver el teatro. The English version is, maybe nobody will come to see the theater. Another example is, tal vez me digan mentiras. I repeat, tal vez me digan mentiras. In English, perhaps they will tell lies to me. Some more examples are, tal vez yo te pueda ayudar. I repeat, tal vez yo te pueda ayudar. In English it is, perhaps I can help you. Next example is, tal vez mañana sea solo un recuerdo. I repeat, tal vez mañana sea solo un recuerdo. In English it is, perhaps tomorrow it will be only a memory. Another example is, tal vez no pensaron en esto. Tal vez no pensaron en esto. The English version, maybe they didn't think about it. Coming to next set of examples, no me esperes. Probablemente yo coma fuera. I repeat, no me esperes. Probablemente yo coma fuera. In English, it is translated as, don't wait for me. Probably, I will eat outside. Next example is, has visto a Juan? No, pero posiblemente esté en su cuarto. No, pero posiblemente esté en su cuarto. The English equivalent is, have you seen Juan? No, but perhaps he is in his room. The next example is with seguramente. Seguramente nos veamos el sábado. I repeat, seguramente nos veamos el sábado. The English version is, perhaps we will meet on Saturday. Another example is, seguramente ella tenga mucho para contar cuando vuelva de las vacaciones. I repeat, seguramente ella tenga mucho para contar cuando vuelva de las vacaciones. The English equivalent is, surely she will have many things to say once she returns from vacations. A lo mejor is an expression which means perhaps. But interestingly, it is used only with the indicative and doesn't admit the use of the subjunctive. Let us see some examples. A lo mejor llueve mañana. I repeat, a lo mejor llueve mañana. The English equivalent is, perhaps it rains tomorrow. Next example is, si mañana hace sol, a lo mejor podemos ir a la playa. I repeat, si mañana hace sol, a lo mejor podemos ir a la playa. The English version is, if tomorrow it is sunny, perhaps we can go to the beach. Ojalá is an interjection of Arabic origin and invokes the name of Allah. It means, may God grant that, and expresses great desire. It can be translated as, I hope to God, I hope, or if only. Let us see some examples. Ojalá le toque la lotería. I repeat, ojalá le toque la lotería. In English, may God grant that you win the lottery. Next example is, ojalá no sea grave. I repeat, ojalá no sea grave. In English, I hope it is not serious. Next example, ojalá also at times is followed by K, as illustrated below. Ojalá que tenga suerte. I repeat. Ojalá que tenga suerte. The English equivalent is, I hope that you are lucky. Next sentence is, ojalá que venga el Papá Noel. I repeat, ojalá que venga el Papá Noel. The English version is, I hope that Santa Claus comes. Coming to the next set of expressions with which the subjunctive is to be used, we have the indefinite expressions with quiera. Many words are made indefinite by adding the suffix quiera. Such words are followed by the subjunctive. Examples are quien quiera que, cuando quiera que, donde quiera que, como quiera que, cualquiera que. I repeat, quien quiera que, cuando quiera que, donde quiera que, como quiera que, cualquiera que. Let us take up some examples to understand the functioning of the subjunctive with these expressions. Quien quiera que seas, no importa. I repeat, quien quiera que seas, no importa. In English, whoever you are, it does not matter. Next example is, cuando quiera que él vuelva, yo lo estaré esperando. I repeat, cuando quiera que él vuelva, yo lo estaré esperando. The English equivalent is, whenever he may return, I will be waiting for him. Next example is, donde quiera que vayas, no verás tal belleza. I repeat, donde quiera que vayas, no verás tal belleza. The English equivalent is, wherever you may go, you will not see such beauty. Next example is, como quiera que nosotros trabajemos, él dirá que hay mejor manera. I repeat, como quiera que nosotros trabajemos, él dirá que hay mejor manera. The English equivalent is, however we may work, he will say that there is a better way. Next example is, cualquiera que estudie este libro podrá aprender fácilmente. I repeat, cualquiera que estudie este libro podrá aprender fácilmente. The English version is, anyone who reads this book will be able to learn easily. Now, let us see the next set of usages of the subjunctive in the constructions of K plus the subjunctive. Wishes or desires are expressed in a shorter form by beginning with K. Let us see some sentences to clarify the functioning of the K plus subjunctive format. Que tengas un buen día. I repeat, que tengas un buen día. The English equivalent is, have a good day. Next example is, que lo pases muy bien. I repeat, que lo pases muy bien. English version is, have a good time. Next is, que aproveche. Que aproveche. The English version is, enjoy your meal. Next example is que te vayas. Que te vayas. The English version, get out. Another example, que te salga bien el examen. I repeat, que te salga bien el examen. English version, may you do well in the exam. Así plus present subjunctive is normally used for negative sentences or cursing. Let us see some examples. Pepe se ha bebido todo el vino. Así le siente mal. I repeat. Pepe se ha bebido todo el vino. Así le siente mal. The English equivalent. Pepe has drunk all the wine. May he gets a stomach upset. Next example is asesino. Así te pudras en la cárcel. I repeat. Asesino. Así te pudras en la cárcel. Murderer. May you suffer in jail. The present perfect subjunctive. The present perfect subjunctive is formed by using the present subjunctive of the auxiliary verb haber and the past participle. The present perfect subjunctive is a compound verb formed with the haber verb and past participle of the main verb. You can see the conjugations of haber are used in the present tense of the subjunctive, like yo, haya, tú, hayas, él, ella, usted, haya, nosotros, hayamos, vosotros, hayáis, ellos, ellas, ustedes, hayan. This is combined with the participle of the verb. The present perfect subjunctive is used when a verb requiring the subjunctive in the main clause is in the present, future, or present perfect. You must have noticed that the same holds true for the regular present subjunctive case as well. So, what is the difference between the two? The present subjunctive is used when the dependent clause is in the present or future, while the present perfect subjunctive is used when the dependent clause is in the past. Let us see some examples to understand the concept of the present perfect subjunctive. Es posible que ellos no te hayan reconocido. I repeat. Es posible que ellos no te hayan reconocido. The English version is, it is possible that they have not recognized you. Next example is, ella está contenta de que tú hayas llegado. I repeat, ella está contenta de que tú hayas llegado. The English equivalent is, she is happy that you have arrived. With negative crane, we know the dependent clause takes the subjunctive. No creo que ellos hayan llegado. I repeat. No creo que ellos hayan llegado. The English version is, I don't believe that they have arrived. Next example is, no creerá que tú hayas llegado. I repeat, no creerá que tú hayas llegado. He won't believe that you have arrived. Next example. Mi hermano duda que yo haya leído su secreta carta. I repeat. Mi hermano duda que yo haya leído su secreta carta. The English version is, my brother doubts that I have read his secret letter. The next example is, me alegro de que hayáis disfrutado de las vacaciones en España. I repeat, me alegro de que hayáis disfrutado de las vacaciones en España. The English version is, I am happy that you all have enjoyed your vacations in Spain. Another example is, me asusta que en mi ausencia mi madre haya descubierto todos mis cómics en mi habitación. I repeat, me asusta que en mi ausencia mi madre haya descubierto todos mis cómics en mi habitación. The equivalent translation in English is, it scares me that my mother has discovered all my comics in my absence from my room. Let's take another example. No me importa que me haya engañado porque ya estaba harta de él. I repeat. No me importa que me haya engañado porque ya estaba harta de él. I am not bothered that he cheated on me because I was already tired of him. Next example is, lamento que ellas no hayan podido venir a la fiesta. I repeat, lamento que ellas no hayan podido venir a la fiesta. The English equivalent is, we regret that they haven't come to the party. Next example is, es bueno que hayamos hablado. I repeat, es bueno que hayamos hablado. It is good that we have talked. Next example is, al profesor le gusta que hayamos escrito 5 ensayos en esta semana. I repeat, a profesor le gusta que hayamos escrito 5 ensayos en esta semana. The English version is, the professor likes that we have written 5 essays in this week. Another example, es una lástima que ustedes no hayan traído sus motos para la carrera. I repeat, es una lástima que ustedes no hayan traído sus motos para la carrera. In English, it is a shame that you haven't brought your motorcycles for the race. Next example is, me encanta que mis hijos me hayan llamado. I repeat, me encanta que mis hijos me hayan llamado. The English version is, I am delighted that my kids have called me. Next example is, me enoja que ella no haya dicho la verdad. I repeat, me enoja que ella no haya dicho la verdad. English version is, I am mad that she hasn't told the truth. So now we have covered all possible uses of the present subjunctive and also discussed the present perfect subjunctive. Please be aware that all the aspects of the subjunctive are of utmost importance for any learner of Spanish language because it is frequently used by Spanish speaking people in various contexts. Thank you and gracias.